There's a new hit in town, Walt Disney's Pinocchio. The Andrews sisters bring you one of its gayest melodies, Got No Strings.
All right, so I've already applied foundation and concealer, and the products I used will be listed below. These are the products. And then I'm going to move on to eyeshadow primer. I'm using the Toofaced Shadow Insurance, as always, applied from lid to brow. And I'm going to follow that with Shroom by MAC, applied from lid to brow. And what that's going to do is just provide a slightly subtle shimmer from the lash line to the eyebrows. And then I'm going to immediately move on to Pin Curl by MAC, which is a silvery shade. It's very subtle also. I'm applying that to the lid only. And I'm going to blend upwards using a blending brush. And that's going to just lay the basis for the whole look. I'm going to follow with Satin Taupe by MAC, which is just a cool-toned, frosty taupe shade. And that's going to the crease. And I'm going to also carry that underneath the eye, just to kind of add a little bit of definition. This whole eye is very subtle and very shimmery, and we want to make sure that we keep it consistent throughout. So that's what we're doing now. And then I'm going to move straight on to blending. And I'm using my Pirouette blending brush, which is a really great dense blending brush. I'm blending all those colors together. And then following up with this matte soft blue from the Coastal Scents 78 palette, I'm applying that to the lid only. This isn't going to be a very colorful look. It's just a subtle bit of blue on the lid. And that is actually going to cause, or is going to really mimic the look that Disney gave her. And then I'm going to take the Satin Taupe and the Shroom and just further define the lid and the brow bone. Not really define, but just to further accentuate those two areas. And then I'm going to move on to the shimmery, the really shimmery part of this look, which is going to be provided by a few frosty eyeshadows. The first one is this vanilla shade by Pixi. It's in this palette. It's kind of a shimmery vanilla color. And I'm going to take a small brush and apply that to the inner eyelid, just the inner eyelid, not exactly the tear duct, just kind of spreading it out towards the lid itself. And then I'm going to apply this very, very shimmery pearl pigment by NYX. I'm going to apply that to the tear duct alone. And that's going to really open up the eyes and give this kind of a festive quality without being really in your face. And from there, I'm going to apply my winged liner. I am using a black eyeshadow just dipped in water, and that's all this is. It's going to provide a more subtle wing. And I really like the difference between using this type of a liner and using a more of a harsh liquid liner. And then I'm going to take this glittery liner by a Hard Candy, I think, and it's actually it's not pigmented at all. It's just supplying a shimmer to the, we're going to apply it over the winged liner, and it just provides a bit of glitter to that area and really softens up the line as well. And then I'm going to use some false lashes. This is number 33s by ModLash, and I'm going to cut those in half, but first I'm going to prime my eyelashes with a good lengthening mascara. This is Illegal Lengths by Maybelline. And I'm doing a review on that for this week as well. And I cut those eyelashes in half using the inner corner of the eyelashes where they get short at the inner corner, but I'm applying those to the outer corner of my eye to give it a doe-eyed look. Now I'm moving on to blush. This is an Illamasqua blush. It's very matte, but it's peach. And we're going to apply that to the cheekbone area, kind of blending upwards. And then we're going to apply a highlighter. The one I'm using is by Lorac, but it's a very subtle shimmer. It's not glittery at all. And I'm applying that to the cheekbones, to the tops of the cheekbones, the bridge of the nose. So that kind of marries the glowy eyes with the glowy skin. We don't want to overdo it though, so don't apply it to the forehead or the chin. And from there, I'm going to move on to, what am I moving on to? Lips, I think. I'm going to line my lips with a nude lip liner. This is by Bare Minerals. And I'm just going to define my lips very, very subtly. And then I'm going to top that off with a pink lipstick. The one I'm using is by Senna. It's called Paris Pink. And it's a very muted, kind of warm pink, which I really, really love. I wear this lipstick all the time. I really love it. And then I'm going to apply a shimmery, kind of champagne-tinged pink lip gloss just to the center of the bottom lip. And what that's going to do is just make the lips look fuller and kind of just once again marry that whole glowy look together and keeps the look consistent over the whole face. That's all for the makeup. Let's move on to hair.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are, anything your heart desires will come to you. If your heart is in your dream, no request is too extreme. When you wish upon a star, as dreamers do, fate is kind. She brings to those who love the sweet fulfillment of their secret longing. Like a boat out of the blue, fate steps in and sees you through. Mama, when you wished upon a star, your dreams come true. Secret long, yes. Like a boat out of the blue, fate steps in and sees you through. Baby, when you wish upon a star, your dream. When you wished upon the stars, makes no difference who you are, your dreams are gone. Ba ba bo, yeah.